Hi friends, welcome to my another video. In one of my previous video, I discuss why we need a starter in starting up the three-phase induction motor though it is a self-starting machine. In that video, I explained that a starter has no role in starting up the three-phase induction machine, but it's just limiting the high inrush current that has been produced at the time of starting of three-phase induction motor. Why we need to limit that high inrush current, we will discuss here in this video, and after that we will discuss the technique that how we will achieve it. Why we need to limit this high inrush current which has been produced at the time of starting, because it poses a significant threat to the motor insulation, motor windings and the overall lifespan of the motor. This high inrush current also creates a voltage dip situation at the time of starting of three-phase induction motor, which is undesirable, and the electrical authority may fine for this voltage dip to the consumer. To limit this high inrush current, we have a very popular technique, that is the star delta technique. In this video, we will discuss how this star delta technique reduces the high inrush current. But before this, I will brush up how and why there is a high inrush current at the time of starting of three-phase induction motor, and how and why this high inrush current will vanish once the motor reach its rated speed. Once we give the three-phase supply to the stator winding of the motor, then the stator winding of the motor produces the rotating magnetic field, which will rotate at the speed of synchronous speed. But the rotor at the time of starting is in the standstill position, so the rate of flux cut by the rotor short-circuited bar is very high. As per the Faraday's law, there will be the high induced EMF, and accordingly there will be the high inrush current. Due to the linking of rotating magnetic flux with the rotor bar, rotor feel forced to rotate, and the rotor start rotating. Once the rotor start rotating, the flux linking to the rotor bar by this rotating magnetic field will get reduced, and once the rotor get its rated speed, the flux linkage will be minimum, and accordingly the EMF induced in the rotor bar and the current accordingly will be minimum. So hope I am clear that at the time of starting of the motor, the rotor is in a standstill position and the rotating magnetic field is rotating with synchronous speed, then the flux linking with the rotor bar is high. But once the rotor start rotating, the linking of flux get reduced, so the induced EMF in the rotor and the current in the rotor get reduced. That's why there is high inrush current at the time of starting, but once the motor get its rated speed, the motor have only the rated current. Now let us come to our original topic, that is how this star delta technique reduces the high inrush current. If you see the winding of the motor, then all the three winding have free terminals and connected in the connection box of the motor in the following manner. To make it in the star connection, we need to connect in terminal of the each winding together as shown in the picture. To make the winding in delta connection, we need to connect the terminal of the winding as shown. If we give the three-phase supply to the star connected winding, then each coil of the motor get much reduced voltage, whereas if we apply the three-phase supply to the delta connected winding, then each coil gets same applied voltage. So the trick to reduce the high inrush current at the time of starting is to connect the winding of the motor in star at the time of starting, and once the motor get its rated speed, we will switch that motor winding into the delta connection. To achieve delta connection of the motor winding at the time of starting, we need to connect the end terminal of the winding in the following manner as shown in the photo, and once the motor get its rated speed, we will change the configuration of the winding by connecting the terminals as shown in the photo. but such manual arrangement is very difficult. To overcome this problem, we use contactors. Contactors automatically convert the motor winding from star configuration to the delta configuration after some interval of time. In order to achieve this, we need to draw three cables from the end terminal of the motor windings. If these terminals connected together, it results the star connection. Achieve the motor winding into the delta configuration, what we need to do is we need to branch the another cable from the end terminal of the motor winding and connect it to the another contactor. If that contactor is active, then the winding of the motor is in the delta configuration. To manage the time between the star contactors and delta contactors, we use timer. I hope you got the idea how this star delta technique reduces the high inverse current at the time of starting. If you want videos on electrical topic, please suggest in the comment section. Thank you.